Welcome back, everyone, to the HWBOT World Series 2016. This could be the second game for today, and I will be here commenting with Dan Kopp from Germany. He's the number one overclocker in the world so far. Dan Kopp, how are you doing just before the second round of this HWBOT World Series for Extreme?
I'm curious, Truth, really curious. It should be really, really interesting. The first stage was just great. I mean, the first semifinal. Great.
And I am from here, from directly in from Sao Paulo, and you are in Germany. And here in Sao Paulo, on the other side of the casting booth, I have Xiala. How are you doing, Timothée? We cannot hear you. Yes, you can hear you now.
Okay, well, now we can hear me.
Yeah, okay. Now it's good.
I'm going very well, Truffman.
So can you say hi to the camera in front of you?
Hey, guys.
So you will be commenting for us what is happening on the other side, what kind of temperature the guys have, and what is the small issue that they might have during the few settings. So as you can see, on the right side, we will have one of the overclocker. On the left side, we will have one of the other overclocker. And so far, they are just setting up the system. We will see how they do that in the next few minutes. Dan Kopp, what are you expecting from this special second round? We don't know yet the benchmark, but we know that the guys did qualify for this.
I'm just expecting another great and how do you call it?
Tight competition.
Great and tight competition. It was so close, the other competition, and this semifinal should be the same, I guess. So I'm really looking forward.
I can't
Let's
wait
start
for
right
it
now.
I can't wait for it, and we will see Paychex and Noms competing against each other in this special round. And before we start the run, because we're still waiting for some refill for the liquid nitrogen, all the guys already used everything they had at their disposal this morning for the qualifier and during the first round of the semifinal. So we are just waiting for more liquid nitrogen to arrive. It's a bit tight here with the security because there's more than 10,000 people in this event. So we need to be very careful and make sure all the safety is good. Before we go live with all the details, we can always check our giveaway that is going on right now on overclocking-tv.com/raffle or on the YouTube, on the Facebook fan page of HWBOT. You can win one of the Seasonic PSU, the P1000 power supply, an extremely good water supply. Seasonic is a partner of the Complete World Tour event for 2016. Thank you, Seasonic. This is going to be awesome. So you guys can expect to win some of the awesome prizes from Seasonic in the next few events as well. In entering this giveaway, you can also win one of the HyperX SSD. There's two HyperX SSD of 120 gigs to win, and one of the three thermal flasks from HWBOT. You can use that for coffee, or you can use that for LN2. As you can see right behind me, that is the second dewar of liquid nitrogen that just arrived. So that means the competition will be able to start in the next few minutes. Dan Kopp, who do you think could be the leader at first for this round?
I have absolutely no idea because I don't know any of him of them. So both of them are pretty new faces, I think. But it should be very interesting. PHXH, I think, is his name. ended up third. Was he third or second?
It was second on the qualifier for this final for the Extreme guys.
Yeah. So I think he should deserve a good semifinal right now. But nobody knows which benchmark. Nobody knows what are they going to bench and I'm curious.
That would be interesting to see for the draw. And guys, as we did explain you, they did qualify during 3 hours this morning on three different benchmark: SuperPi 32M 5 GHz, GPU Pi for CPU 1 billion 5 GHz, and maximum memory clock. Out of these three stages this morning, AAC Schenk and PHHX, Joe 90BR and Noms finished in the top four. That's why they are actually now competing for the prize here. And what the guys can win is a flight to Germany for the end of the season, for the final of this championship.
Yay, Germany is so nice. Good for the guys to be there.
Coming from a German guy, I don't think that's quite... Oh, we seem to have a slight issue with one of the camera. We'll try to fix that. During that time, we can say that Peixe Agashi, actually, that's how you should say it in Portuguese. So P is P, X is she, or she, H is Aga, and she again. So Peixe Agashi. So Peixe Agashi would be a. Will be like it. Dankop, I need to go fix one of the cameras, so I'll let you discuss what could be done in the next few minutes. I know that they are doing the drawing right now, so let's switch to that.
Okay, Chufman.
Okay, you guys can do the draw.
Yes. Okay, so we are going to do the benchmark draw. Basically, what we are going to do here is decide which benchmark they go. So right now, both of them decided to remove XTU, and you decided to remove what? 3D Mark? Okay, so let's draw the benchmark, and hopefully something interesting will come out. It says XTU, so it's vetoed by you, so we take it off. Another one. Memory clock. All right, vetoed by nobody, so memory clock it is for this match. So there's a few more instructions given here by the judges. Yuri from HyperX as well as Massman are making sure that both players have understood the rules and are ready to go. So they decided to go for single channel, it seems. And I will let you go to Truthman. Yeah, it's going to be very interesting, right? So what are your pronostic, Dan Cup?
Memory clock. I mean, when I see it right, they are on air, right? No LN2 on the memory. So
no LN2 on the memory, yes.
And nobody knows what they are using. Is it Samsung? Is it PSC? Is it whatever? Hynix? So very interesting.
Yeah, I'm going to try to figure out what exactly it is and update you on that. So, Dankop, what is the strategy for overclocking memory? What is the technique?
Usually you set the CPU clock and the cache clock, I mean the ring clock, as low as you can. So the multiplier 8 should be used. And then you try starting to boot with the highest possible multiplier on the memories, and afterwards you go up in the OS with the base clock.
Okay. So Truthman is back, it seems.
I am back. I had to fix one of the camera. So what were the benchmark that went in the draw?
We are benching memory clock.
Yeah, so, maximum memory frequency.
That's cool, man.
Was that a tie, or did any of the overclocker add to veto?
I think one of the vetoes was done. Some of the guys didn't want to bench XTU, so XTU was the first choice, and then they said, okay, veto, and then it was Max Merica.
Interesting. So the two guys are now ready. We'll soon be...
Might be.
We have a Peixe Agashi. Peixe Agashi on the left side. And we have Noms on the right side.
Peixe Agashi, that sounds so Asian, right?
Yeah, it's actually easier.
So much easier than PXHX, right?
So Peixe Agashi on the left side, Noms on the right side. Let us know who you are cheering for on the live chat. They will be overclocking to the maximum frequency they can the DDR3 memory that they have. Be soon starting. Let's make sure that everyone is ready. Timothée, can you check on the other side with the overclockers if everything is going all right?
Sure. So, guys, are you ready? Yeah. Are you ready? Okay, so Truffman, both overclockers are ready. I think the judges are checking something quickly on the side here. Maybe they're... I'm not sure what they're discussing exactly. Some last-minute details probably for the round.
They will have 30 minutes to do the best memory frequency. That will be quite interesting to see. Dan Kopp, do you think they will go full out? Are the overclockers ready?
Yes, overclockers are ready. Yeah. Just a second. Our dear friend Yuri is setting his phone to the clock as well, so he has the timer in sync with you, Truffman.
We are all ready to go. You can see that the guys are still trying to insulate as much as they can. That's going to be lasting for 30 minutes, trying to reach the maximum frequency. So everyone is ready. We will launch the competition for the second run of the HWBOT World Series in 3,
Yuri,
2,
Two.
One, and one. Go!
Go.
So this is it. The guys have to do the best score they can and on the memory frequency. They have to reach the highest memory frequency they could on their system. So we will see what they will do. So far, we are going to see Peishi Agashi. I need to remind that name. Peishi Agashi and Noms fighting to get a place in the grand final. The grand final, the winner of the grand final here will win a plane ticket to go to the HWBOT World Series Championship World Final to happen in December. So let's switch to what they are. What they are seeing. So this is the screen of Peishi Agashi.
There we go. Now let's look what he's doing. Memory frequency, the CPU frequency doesn't matter at all. So let's see what he do. Do we know the memory IC, Truth?
Sorry?
Do we know the memory IC,
need to ask what are the memory IC on the DDR3 memory stick that they have. No one knows so far, so that would be quite interesting to see how they will be clicking in.
Even better for the competition, definitely.
Okay, so Dan Kopp, I'll let you comment on what you're seeing on this screen from Noms.
I mean, right now they are setting the multipliers and they are pretty low. Sure, because we don't know we don't need any CPU speed or cache speed. We just need the memory speed. That's what they are doing right now. If you see right, yes. Now they are at. This is Noms, right?
Yes, this is Noms screen. Yeah. You want to see Peishi Agashi?
No. All good. He's playing with the memories right now. This is the memory tab for the timings, and when you want to raise the memory clock as high as it goes, then you need the lowest timings you can adjust, and that's what he's doing right now. Maybe we can have a look at Peishi Agashi's screen.
Peishi Agashi's screen is right there right now.
Okay, there we go. He's currently at the voltages, playing with them. Maybe he already did the memory timings.
So these guys are the top overclocker in Brazil, and they will be competing today for the next 30 minutes on trying to reach the highest memory frequency that they can. So far, we have Noms that is restarting his system. Waiting to see how that will be going. On the screen at this moment, Peishi Agashi is using 2 volts of VR in while he's using 1.4 of V-Core, 1.4 of V-Ring, and is trying to crank to reduce the voltage on the CPU I/O. Yes, go up. Almost zero. Yeah, it's now positive. Let's go and keep pushing it.
just push it to the limit. That's
As long as it's insane. Not turning red, it's not high enough.
But he's pretty experienced. I mean, that's almost that. That's crazy. I think he would start with around 2,400, maybe 2,800, maybe 3,000. We'll see. Nobody knows the memory IC. That's really interesting.
So what are we supposed to look at right now for this kind of maximum memory frequency? What are the basic strategies so far?
Just start with a setting that boots. Then make a score. It's pretty easy. Just open ZBOZ and you have your score. And afterwards, you can raise the base clock in the OS. Due to the fact we are using Haswell right here, it's only 2.6, maybe 2.7 megahertz on the base clock possible to adjust it in the OS. So afterwards, they have to reboot again and boot with a higher base clock.
What would be your strategy?
That what I've said.
I mean, okay.
That's
because that was the basic one. That was the basic one. Would you do some special tweak after you boot up in the Windows to adjust some of the lower settings to increase that frequency even higher?
That's the most interesting fact in memory overclocking. If you want to reach the highest clocks, there is no tweak. You can't improve it. Maybe there are some small minor tweaks where you just close programs and explorers, whatever, just to keep the load on the CPU and on the memory as low as you can.
Will deactivating some of the core for the CPU would help actually in the memory overclocking?
Yes, for sure. You don't need any cores. You don't need any speed on the CPU, on the cache. You just need pure frequencies on the memories. That's all.
So for this special run, we are not looking for performance increase, just frequency increase.
Yeah, just frequency, no performance at all.
As you can see, the two guys are restarting because they have to go into the BIOS and set up their system. There's all the guys checking if everything is going all right. And there's a major crowd looking at this second run of the semi-final between Pishi Agashi and Noms. So Noms on the right, Noms on the right here, and Pishi Agashi on the left. So here we are. We have Pishi Agashi in the system.
There's the first score, 3,000 megahertz. I've said it, right?
I mean, yep.
There we go. That's just cool. 3,000 megahertz at the first boot. He did it right. Crazy.
But they think they can go even higher than that. So what is the strategy now? That they are in Windows, they just want to increase the base clock, or they can change some of the settings to increase that frequency.
Yeah, maybe the DRAM voltage helps, but usually you just adjust it in the BIOS, and in the OS you are playing with the base clock. So until the CPU stops working, which is usually at 2.6 megahertz plus compared to the boot frequency, and then you have to reboot, boot it with the frequency you have adjusted in the BIOS, in the OS, and then you can try it again.
So this is the score from Noms. He's at 2600 megahertz for the memory. 1333, so that's 2600.
Yeah, that's just a safe boot. I think he will go into the BIOS afterwards if he has checked out the max base clock.
Would you go 1 megahertz by 1 megahertz or just straight like 4
yes,
by 1?
Yes. Shot? Always go 1 by 1, because you never know where's the max. And you never know where's the max on the CPU IMC. I mean, it's not only the memory frequency. Sometimes the memory frequency can go much higher, but you are limited by the IMC of the CPU. So you have to be careful. Just set 1 by 1. And if you are at the very edge, I mean at the limit, then I prefer to go 0.0 by 0.0. So Pretty tough. That's a good benchmark. Good choice of them.
So this is the only benchmark that is solely based on the frequency, and they are not based on the performances by themselves. So this is it. They are rebooting the system. Let's switch to Pesci Agashi that just finished setting up stuff in the BIOS. So far, there is only one score that has been submitted. Pesci Agashi, 1535. Noms, we thought it was 1333. That was the very basic and default score. They are trying to reach the maximum memory clock, and they still have 20 minutes left for that.
They just played 10 minutes and got some good scores right now. That makes the competition very interesting.
As you can see on the scoreboard right now on the screen, 20 minutes left, 1535 megahertz for Pesci Agashi, and 1333 for Noms. That is the basic default frequency right there. This is interesting. This is DDR3. It's not even DDR4. And we have seen DDR4 going to have retail speed at 3200 in the next few months.
Yeah, DDR4 is another technology, and you basically have much higher timings. So that makes it easier to get them higher. The thing is, most of the DDR3 modules are double-sided and dual-ranked, which makes it a little bit faster, but you can't clock it that high like you can on DDR4.
That would be interesting to see extreme overclocking competition on DDR4 in the next few months. But here we are using DDR3 from HyperX. They are all using a Z97 system from Gigabyte, and they are all being powered by the Seasonic PSU 760W, the Platinum Edition. You can see these guys are very focused on what they are doing. The system is actually restarting at the moment. We would see and switch to one of the screens as soon as they get back into the system. This is it. The first to go back in the system is Noms. Noms was going back to the system, and that's it. He is now at 1400.
So we have 2800 right now. It's pretty interesting. He's booting at 127.8 at the base clock right now.
So do you think they could hit a limit in the next few minutes with the base clock?
Yeah, the limits of the base clock are, I think, it's due to the several straps they can use. It's the base clock won't limit them. I don't think so.
In the screen of Pesci Agashi. So they should not be limited by the base clock. That's what you say, basically.
No. Not at all.
DRAM voltage cranking up that to 2 volts. Yes. Come on, guy. No. Come on, push it to 2 volts. 1.96 volt, that would be... The default voltage for DDR3 is 1.65, right?
Yes, it is. Except they are using low voltage RAMs, but I don't think so.
That's definitely not those RAMs.
Those are HyperX. HyperX usually are the performance memory modules, so they are using 1.65.
1.7 volts right here for Noms, taking it very... it's quite conservative. It's quite conservative as a settings for the voltage and the memory.
Yes, it is indeed. I think maybe he's just trying to get the limit of the volts, seeing if it's scaling with voltage, but he only has 30 minutes.
There is less than 17 minutes in this run now. So every time, this is actually quite impressive they choose this benchmark. Maybe because they think, we don't have to do the benchmark, so it's easier. But you have to reboot every time. So you actually lose a lot of time in this kind of competition, trying to reach the maximum frequency.
That's it. That's it. Usually it takes around 30 seconds to boot again, to reboot. And that's 30 seconds. That's 1% of the entire time.
That's as Shantinox said on the live chat, this is a big day for overclocking in Brazil. Indeed, this is the first major international competition to come to Brazil and have a local qualifier right here. And this is the biggest competition of the year, the HWBOT World Series. This is the qualifier for Latin America. We have right now on the screen Noms that is competing against Pishi Agashi, and they're all fighting for a place into the grand final at this local qualifier. The winner of the local qualifier will win a trip to Germany by the end of the year for the worldwide final of the HWBOT World Series Championship.
In Berlin, Germany. I just hope to qualify for that.
There is some discussion going on the live chat regarding what kind of memory you guys have. Let us know what was the last memory you had in DDR3, if you switch to DDR4, or what are the memory you are using right now on your system. Let's switch back to Pishi Agashi. 2.5 GHz for the CPU, but that's not what we're looking at today. 625. He's improving his core by more than 130 MHz on the memory. That is quite a good jump. Still using cast latency 12. Dancop, as the number one overclocker in the world, would you raise that cast latency 12 higher?
Yes, just a little bit. I think cast latency 14 is the max. On DDR3, I'm not sure yet. It's almost 6 months ago I've played DDR3 the last time.
You're one of the early adopters to play with DDR4, so.
yeah, might be. I'm just playing new stuff. The only old school stuff I play is 580, GDX 580. So, I'm usually the guy to play the new stuff. But let's have a look. I mean, come on. He's at 1660. That's 3330. Great result.
Okay. I just got the information from the competition side that they had some slight issue with one of the software, and I also got the confirmation that they're not limited to cast 12 in this competition, so they can go higher if they want. They can go lower if they want, but that's not going to be quite useful. So that's, so far they are not touching these settings. We'll see what will happen. I just got the information right now that they might have some issue with one of the software, and that's why on the screen of Pishi Agashi there was actually styling some stuff. So let's go back to Noms right now. He's booting at 1457, improving his base score of 1430, 20 MHz more. That is just playing with the base clock so far. 132 MHz of reference clock, 1.95 of VCCC in. And if we look at the memory voltage, it's at 1.76. You can see the OS is in Portuguese because all the guys here speak Portuguese in Brazil. You guys are restarting their system at the moment. Dan Kopp, what is your take right now? There's 12 minutes left in this competition. What do you think? Do you think that Noms can make it back in the lead against Pishi Agashi?
Yeah, I think maybe he's using a higher voltage right now. Because he went straight into the BIOS after booting, because he saw it's very, very stable what he had right now. So maybe he's now using another multiplier for the memory and booting like Pishi Agashi with 1500 plus. So yeah, let's see what it does right now.
So far, they're just restarting the system, and once they will be in the OS will be able to switch back the system. And this is it. This is NOMS in the BIOS going for the settings. He played a little bit with the PCI Express frequency, but maybe that was not worth it for him. So he's put that back to the default 100 MHz. The system multiplier is at 29.33. Let's see if he can reach higher than that.
So that's almost 3K. So he's pretty close to PCI Agassi right now.
You can see they're pouring liquid nitrogen on the CPU just to cool down some of the controller for the memory. But I don't see them using the NN2 on the memory itself.
Would it be allowed?
I think they can do whatever they want. As long as they respect the rule of using a certain type of hardware.
Okay. So I think with LN2 on the memories, we could have seen something around 4K here.
Yeah, but they're not using LN2 today here, maybe because they have just a few minutes of preparation before the competition actually starts. And I guess that they don't want to have an issue with the condensation either, because if you do have condensation issue, you need to stop everything and start again. In the 30 minutes that they had, this might not be actually fast enough. 10 minutes left, and we can see the screen of PCI Agassi right now. No, please don't activate the XMP for this competition.
Maybe he wants to start the game afterwards.
Settings turbo and not extreme. 2 volt of VR in, 1.4 for the V core. CPU ring is going to 1.4 as well. But he's not quite sure what to use here. Oh, this is it. We have to increase from the very bottom. I don't think you can type directly the number in the BIOS.
You can, but only if you have a numpad on your keyboard.
Oh yeah, and this one doesn't have, I guess. That's the trick. So close to zero, 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 zero. Yeah, zero, and now it's positive, and it's keep on going until I guess 250.
Go higher. Higher, more. Come on, don't stop. Nope.
Give me those volts. Give me those volts. No, you can push more. You can push to almost 200. Come on. Yes. Yes, that's
yes.
It. Over 200.
There
that
we
is
go.
Good.
There we go.
And then we do the same thing for the I.O. There is a score from NOMS. He was... I didn't quite get the right speed.
Where are we at?
On NOMS, 1495 megahertz. The memory. There is over 150 megahertz difference between the two scores at the moment, and there's only 7 minutes and 50 seconds left in this second semifinal of the AWBOT World Series 26. It is rebooting, going back into the BIOS. PCI Agassi is still in the BIOS, playing around with the numbers. 165 volt extra, 165 volt extra for the CPU I/O voltage. Gonna do pretty much the same for the digital one. Plus 0.200. Now come on, don't reduce that one. So DRAM voltage, going to adjust that one. I guess it's going to be like 1.85 or 2 volts. It's going to 2 volts. That is actually good. Keep on pushing it, man. Keep on pushing this.
For DDR3, it's okay. Really.
I just got the information that it seems that the GTL, the tool, is not really well working with the BCLK overclocking. So that was maybe one of the reasons why they were trying to overclock and add some small issue.
But the good thing is both of them have the problems. So
yeah, so that's a level playing field for both of them. This is it, going to the cast latency, going to change them. He was at cast latency 12 just for his run before, and he's now at 11, so that might actually impact him on the frequency as well. Switching to the 26.6 multiplier for this one. Let's go to the memory timing. Go change that memory timing, man. Don't let it on auto. During that time, Noms is actually still rebooting. Didn't change much of his setting so far. This is it. Bishiyagashi.
Bishiyagashi is playing Cast Latency 13 right now. And yeah, common rate 2.
The two guys are actually rebooting their system at the moment. There's only 5 minutes and 34 seconds left in this second round of the competition. You can go and check out the screen of Noms. It will did not even modify that much. He just made a jump to 1539 megahertz for his score. You can see the two guys are actually discussing on some of their settings, but don't forget they are competing today. This is a very friendly environment, but they are still competing. So maybe they give false information to the other guys. Who knows? That would be fun to have the headset on the guys so we could hear what they are saying. Even yeah, though it would be in Portuguese, so we would not understand anything.
No, not really. But maybe some of us. Yeah, it's a very friendly environment. I mean, it's usually very friendly on overclocking competitions. So
and especially
all the guys
here,
know
all the guys,
other.
Yeah, and all the guys here in Brazil are super nice. Like all the people we saw at the campus party are super super friendly, and they all want to learn more on what is happening. That is perfect.
Yeah, I saw the show from Doug Venom. He did a lot of stuff for the newcomers. Really great stuff.
So 1586 1569 megahertz for Noms. He's getting back. He's getting back to Bishiyagashi, and still 100 megahertz difference, but he can make it step by step to go catch him at the very last point. There is only less than 4 minutes now in this second semi-final of the HWBOT World Series here in the Latin America stop of the HWBOT World Tour.
Yeah, only 3 minutes 30 seconds left. I'm so curious. What happens? I mean, right now we are talking about 100 megahertz difference between them. Bishiyagashi. Where's his screen?
Bishiyagashi is still restarting at the moment.
Okay.
Both still restarting at the moment. Not quite sure what is happening with the system. Go and see what is in the BIOS. Just need a few minutes. As the guy are actually quite fast in the BIOS, sometimes he doesn't have the time to pick it up for the system to display it. So this is it. Is already back into rebooting the system. You can see the two screens are off at this very moment. Maybe,
but
they're not sure what will be going on, if that can boot or not.
But we haven't seen any blue screen right now.
No, and it's actually impressive because it's memory overclocking, and usually the blue screen happen when you're pushing too hard on the memory.
Yeah, when you push the memory too hard. Before we have seen all the blue screens with a 124. 124 on the blue screen always means two less V-core or ring voltage. Or two less, how is it called? VCCN, the input voltage. And when you get a blue screen with while memory overclocking, it's not 124, the code is 50. So I thought we would have seen here. Maybe we will see now.
There's less than 2 minutes in this competition, and so far the guys are struggling to start up their system once again. So as you can see, there's a lot of people as well watching this semi-final of the HWBOT World Series here in the Campus Party in Brazil. So these guys have 1 minute and 30 seconds to boot the system, show the frequency to the judge, Massman, and start again to try to improve what they have.
Watch the crowd. Overclocking is very interesting.
And just... we We have less than 100 megahertz difference between the two guys. It would be very close. I really hope that Noms can get a decent score. As you see, Noms is going back into the BIOS, trying to make the few change. Going back into the few settings. Right now you can see it. He put the base clock at 107, but not quite sure if this would be enough for him to start. This is it. We are closing into the 30 seconds mark left in this competition. Less than 30 seconds. You can feel that these guys have the pressure. They are both trying to restart and boot the system and show the frequency to the judge. Massman, they are all using liquid nitrogen, and this is it. There's 20 seconds left in this second round of the competition. Will Pishi Agashi make it to go against Schenkel in the grand final right here, or Noms in the other ones? This is it. Noms is back in the BIOS. There's 5 minutes left, 3 seconds left. This is quite close.
One.
And this is too bad. This is over. This is the end of this round. Sadly, Noms didn't manage to catch up on his opponent, Pishi Agashi. So that means Pishi Agashi is going live to the grand final against Schenkel, while Noms will go against the previous winner, Joe90BR, for the bronze. So we will have. The next grand final will be A.C. Schenk against P.C. Agashi, and Joe90BR against Noms for defining who will be the third guy. So that means there is still two match to have here at the HWBOT World Series competition for the Latin America stop of the HWBOT World Tour. And we are back live on the commentary right here. This was a very well done competition by the two guys. Sadly enough, Noms didn't manage to catch it with Pishi Agashi. Dankop, what did you think about that that round especially?
It's quite interesting. Now we have the first and the second out of the qualifiers in the final, yeah, and the third and the fourth in the bronze round. I think all of them did quite well. Pishi Agashi is very surprising. I mean, 100 megahertz on the memories is quite a lot, but we'll see which benchmark we're gonna see in the finals. And yeah, still one of the best live competitions I've ever seen. Great job. Oh,
as there were some, they had some issue with the software. I guess that they're just finishing the run. Let me check with the judge if everything is all fine and see what's going on. Okay, this is really over now. So that's the thing. They had a few issues with the system, so they give them 2 minutes more. But that didn't change anything because the score didn't change at all. This is a nice game with Pishi Agashi against Noms. And you can see Pishi Agashi is the winner and the crowd cheering. This is a quite fair play game right here. They wanted to be sure. So now they have to dry up the system, heat up the complete system, and then go back to their benching stage while they will be preparing for their next game. So Pishi Agashi will be facing A. Schenk in the grand final. And just before that, we will see Noms facing Joe90BR for the bronze crown. Dankop, what did you think about the two first rounds? The level playing of these Brazilian overclockers is actually quite impressive.
Yeah, sure. And W prime was very interesting. Memory overclocking was more than interesting. I think that should have been in the finals, because you don't need really that much performance. It's just getting the max out of the hardware. And yeah, that's really interesting. I think all four contestants did a really great job. They only had 30 minutes. I mean, 30 minutes, you can, that's not much.
It's not much, and everything can happen in 30 minutes, especially if you eat a callback. You have to re-eat everything and start again, and you lose some precious minutes right there.
truth, you have a code bug. You have problems with the memories. You don't know the memory ICs. I mean, we don't even know what memory ICs they use. So they don't know either. So, yeah, honestly spoken, I'm very afraid of the qualification in Taipan.
That would be quite tough, especially for you, because there's going to be a lot of guys that want to do a face-off with you. You are the number one overclocker in the world right now, Dan Kopp, and there's a lot of people that want to beat you at this.
Yeah, sure, that's normal. I mean, yeah, that's usual. If you're first, everybody wants to beat you.
Let's try to see if I can get some words from the other side of the stream booth with the guys. As you can see, they are right now, the two overclockers are eating up the system because they need to dry everything and continue benching for the fun with the liquid nitrogen on the under the table right here. So we will I will be back in a few seconds, just checking if I can get someone to speak about all that. Dan Kopp, during that time, what would be your strategy if you have to go to the final?
I'm not really sure. Sure, the benchmark is important. Furthermore, just staying calm. I mean, not if you are not calm enough. I mean, you need the right passion, sure, and you need some more.
If you are stressed, that will be bringing bad things, especially for your score. That's pretty sure.
If you're nervous, that's not good for a live final, and especially if you are in a final of 1v1. I've never been there. I want to. That's so interesting, really.
So this is it. We are managing to get someone from the other side of the table. This is Timo Teixeira, and you can look at the camera on the other side and say hi.
I have a torch in between, but yeah, hi guys.
So how was it going for you guys close to the contestant? Was the battle very tense?
It was pretty intense at the start. I think the guys were not really expecting anything like this from the beginning. They were also having some issues, it seems, with some configuration, something that was not setting properly right. I'm not too sure what it was, since I was taking picture, I was not really looking at the screens. It was pretty cool, actually.
There was some question on the chat as well on why don't they use the liquid nitrogen on the memory sticks.
Because the thing is to prepare memory for LN2, you have to kind of prepare up front, and because the memory benchmark was drawn just before the match, they didn't have one kit with and one kit without the preparation and the pots for LN2 cooling on the memory.
And of course they were all using a single stick for this memory frequency overclocking, so they tried to do all their chins on their side for that. Timothée, we will be taking a short break. Do you have anything to say to all the viewers from everywhere in the world watching this live right now?
So thanks, guys, for watching. This is Overclocking TV, and we're live from the HWBOT World Series 2016 Extreme Finals. This is professional esports at an overclocking level. We're going to be here again for the next part, which is the bronze match for... Do you know, well, who is going to be third and fourth, right? And we will be back for that in about, let's say, technically half an hour, if everything goes well.
So that means 45 minutes from now.
No, the guys are almost done unmounting, and I know the other guys are rebuilding their rigs because they had to dry them up in between, you know. For example, Jonah and TBR, who's qualified, as well as NOMS, etc. So they are both like... making sure it's well dried and ready to go for one more round.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Timothée, for this information from live on the scene. Dan Kopp will be taking a short break, about 15-20 minutes, and we'll be coming back for the third round of this HWBOT World Series Latin America final. That will be for the bronze, deciding who will be third and who will be fourth in this qualification. So guys, stay tuned, and if you're not fan yet of us on Facebook, you can find us on facebook.com/overclockingTV. You can find us as well on all the social media, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and of course Facebook. If you want to win some awesome prizes from our partners Seasonic, HyperX, and HWBot, you can go on overclocking-tv/raffle, and you will be able to win some of these awesome prizes. There's a PSU to win, two SSDs, and three thermal flasks. Dancop, thank you very
much.
Don't miss that. Oh yeah. Dancop, we'll find you back in the next few minutes, and we will be taking a short break. Thank you guys. Stick around.
Bye-bye.